Hello everyone, welcome to TLRZ. Today's video, I will explain the difference between hard disk drive and solid state drive, and what kind of hard drive should you buy for your computer. So let's get started. Everyone knows what is hard drive. You can store any kind of data on that drive. When you open and check your computer's hard drive, you will see operating system, install software and other files. But why a computer need hard drive? Can a computer run without hard drive? The answer is yes. You can open a computer and test all your hardware before starting a boot process. For the boot process, you must choose boot files from the hard drive in the BIOS boot sequence. On the other hand, if you have multiple flash drives, you can choose that drive without installing operating system on your computer hard drive. Otherwise, if your computer can use pre-boot execution environment, you can boot with that. There are two types of hard drive: hard disk drive and solid state drive. Hard disk drive is like traditional hard drive, and is situated in internal drive B and attached to the motherboard. There is also a standard drive build. You can combine two or three hard drives in that build. Let's go back to the hard disk drive. The whole component of the hard drive is inside the SC case. On the back side of the hard drive, there is a circuit board called disk controller. That controller controls the hard disk drive to cooperate with the computer. When you find data on computer, the disk controller commands the accelerator, and the accelerator controls the rewrite arm and head to move across the mechanical bladder for accessing data. At that time, the spindle motor turns the mechanical bladders, which contain a series of bladders. So it may take some time before information is accessed. This way of accessing data is similar to the way of vinyl record album work. The arm and head of the hard drive moves very fast from one area of the disk to another area. The spindle speed measured in rotation per minute defines HDD performance. If the spindle speed is fast, the condition of your HDD is good. If your HDD has 5400 RPM, it means the rewrite speed of your HDD is around 75 MB per second. If your HDD has 7200 RPM, it means the rewrite speed is around 100 MB per second. If the spindle speed is 100,000 RPM, it means the rewrite speed of your HDD is 140 MB per second. If your spindle speed is slow, the rewrite speed is slow. So if that happens, you should buy a new one. Or if you draw your HDD from a higher place, you should buy a new one because it don't have shock resistance.
Another one.
Right now, you can choose two form factor of HDD, 2.5 inches and 3.5 inches. 2.5 inches is mostly used for laptops, 3.5 inches is for server and desktop computer. You can also buy external hard disk drive. The price of external hard disk drive is a little bit more than internal drive. SSD stands for solid state drive. It stores data on memory chips called NAND flash memory and not depend on spinning disk or moving backs like HDD. It has no moving backs, and the whole process for SSD is determined by its controller, also known as processor. So the data accessing time is very, very fast. It also lets you lose data with vibration or shock damage. It works like RAM in computer. But however, RAM are volatile, so they lose data when you turn off your computer. But SSD are non-volatile, so they don't lose data even power loss or other issues. Check for every side, SSD are fast, robust, energy efficient than HDD. There are 5 different types of SSD. The first one is SATA SSD. SATA means Serial Advanced Technology Attachment, and it is the first generation of SSD. Their form factors is the same as 2.5 inches HDD. SATA SSD use SATA 3 interface and SATA cable. Their rewrite speed is around 450 to 550 megabyte per second. New version of HDD use SATA 3 interface, but their rewrite speed is around 70 to 200 megabyte per second. Server SSD is lowest among all types of SSD, but it's still faster than all kinds of HDD. Another one is mSATA SSD. It is also known as mini SATA SSD. It uses mSATA connector, which was created in September 2009. It is designed for laptops and other devices which can use normal SATA SSD. The speed of mSATA SSD is comparable to SATA 3 SSD, and the main difference between them is the connector. It is slightly expensive than normal SATA SSD. The next one is NGFF M.2 SSD. This is the refinement version of mSATA SSD. M.2 is an expansion slot that can connect with SATA 3.0, PCI Express 3.0, and USB 3.0. But mSATA SSD can connect with M.2 slot. NGFF M.2 SSD is also called SATA M.2 SSD. If USB is the same as SATA 3 SSD and mSATA SSD. If the motherboard of your desktop PC or laptop has M.2 slot, you can improve your computer's performance with SATA M.2 SSD. Most of the motherboards M.2 slots support SATA M.2 SSD, but some of the motherboard doesn't support it. Another one is NVMe PCIe M.2 SSD. It is also known as NVMe M.2 SSD. Like a name, it also uses M.2 slot. Some older motherboard doesn't support NVMe M.2 SSD, but most modern motherboard that you can buy right now support NVMe M.2 SSD. Some modern motherboard only support NVMe M.2 SSD. The USB may be 4 times or 5 times faster than SATA based SSD. Normal gaming on the SSD will not show bigger speed changes than SATA based SSD. But for the person who use video editing in 4K or higher resolution will see obvious speed changes. But its price is higher than SATA based SSD. The last one is NVMe PCIe connector SSD. The interface of this is the same as NVMe PCIe M.2 SSD, but to attach with motherboard, this NVMe SSD uses PCIe slot instead of M.2 slot. The advantage of using this is it can produce faster data processing and transfer speed. But noticeable changes can happen when you deal with files which are about 50 GB or more. But most motherboard come out with M.2 slot instead of PCIe filing slot. Once you want to use M.2 slot and your computer have only PCIe slot, you can change it with adapter. Just imagine finding a person in the city. You know that the person lives in this city, but you don't know where he lives. So you take a time to find the person in the whole area of the city. This is how HDD works. On the other hand, with SSD, you must not find the person in normal ways. The person that you wanna meet will appear in front of you immediately, like magic. The two process is very different, right? If you ask me, hey bro, I want to buy a hard drive, what should I buy? So I will answer like that. The first option is, you don't have much money, but you want big storage size. So go buy HDD. You can get big storage size with cheap price, but it is lower than SSD. Another option is, you have money, but you don't want to use much money. So you can buy SATA SSD, mSATA, or SATA M.2 SSD. The last option is, if you want the best quality, go buy NVMe PCIe M.2 SSD. My final suggestion is, go buy SSD and boost your computer's performance. Let's do it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like this video, click like button and subscribe channel. If you have question, comment below. See you in the next video.